Hello and welcome back to another episode of Code Hunt. This time we go to the sixth task of Sector 14, the puzzle sector, and see how I solve this. This is yet another task I originally solved using C Sharp. And I use, since, as you can see up here, I solved it pretty quickly, so this was an easy task, given that the last task was counting the number of different characters or different numbers in this list. It occurred to me pretty quick that the actual task here is to get the distinct elements in the list before here. I think I had like two checks before I came to that idea. And I actually implemented it in C Sharp using just the link helper extension method distinct. But since somehow I cannot switch to C Sharp without breaking the editor, I'm going to implement it this time the same way as I did in the last episode for the distinct count to get the array back. But that actually means that I need to have a solution that generates me an array of dynamic size, I just realized. So I know that I have that somewhere from a previous section. Just quickly copied it over. You might remember that from sector 12. It's just a function that copies an array into a new array that has another length. So it helps me to dynamically allocate the array I actually want to return. So this is result new int array 0. I'm going to extend that whenever needed. This is what I want to return. And then I go over, like in the last episode, saying, okay, and I smaller list.length I plus plus. So I walk over all the numbers, and then I walk over all the numbers I've seen before. So as long as this is smaller than I, I'm going to walk off that one. And in case list I equals list j, I'm going to set duplicate to true, which I initially set to false up here. And if duplicate is still false down here, I'm going to increase the size of my array. So result equals copy of result with result length plus 1. And I'm going to set result length minus 1 to list I in order to get the right value in here. So let's check if that works. It's pretty long code as compared to the just one line C sharp solution where I say list.distinct done. But since we don't have a automatic distinct computation in Java, I have to resort to this solution as long as my C-sharp editor is broken. And apparently PAX likes my solution enough to give me the full skill rating for this pretty lengthy code, which actually solves the task. This is it for today. Thanks a lot for watching. If you liked it, please give me a thumbs up. If not, drop me a comment or send me a message. Let me know what you think. And have a look at my channel and the other things I'm doing. Maybe there's something interesting for you. So, this is goodbye for now, and hope to see you next time.